I'm going to review today and look inside the 7-outlet advanced power strip. And the interesting part of it is that this was offered at Goodwill for $149. So this is way below the cost of production. It seems to be heavily subsidized somewhere, but it's an interesting little contraption. And a couple of months ago, I did a review and a teardown of another similar product of the same company, and the price here was $198, and this was bought at another thrift store, Habitat for Humanity. I looked up on Amazon for the reviews, and there are some reviews complaining that this will flicker, goes on and off independently on the load, and I'm going to check it out. Let's look at the label. So we see that this is UL listed. The maximum volts for the protection to kick in is 400, with maximum amp surge 3 kiloamps. There is a shiny UL listed sticker right here. This is the circuit that makes it tick, meaning that this has a sensor sensing the current in the outlet number 3, this one here. And depending on the load, it will turn on and off these four outlets. So you have a single active electronic component, and this is this little SCR in TO92 case right here. And other than that, there is one diode, 6 resistors, you have one cap, and then we have 48 volts DC relay, and then we also have this little current transformer. These usually are 1 to 1,000 or 1 to 2,000. I kind of assume this is 1 to 1,000. So the winding, the primary winding is just a wire that sticks through it. And then you have 1,000 turns inside. And this will trigger the thyristor, the SCR right here, which in turn will turn on and off the relay. And it works very well with a few caveats. So let me show you a diagram. I did reverse engineer that thing. This is the diagram of that circuit, this board alone. I don't care for this one. This is a standard of a voltage protection, but this is kind of interesting. And at the end of this video, I'm going to play it for a few seconds so you may set it to full screen and then hit the print screen and have a picture of it at the highest resolution if you wish. The SCR is MCR100-8, which is 0.8 amps, 600 volts thyristor. We have a couple of resistors in series, probably to make one go. If there's anything wrong, this one will act as a fuse. And these together are run with half cycles, so this is it goes through a diode, a typical 1,000 volts, 1 amp diode. We have one cap in parallel with the coil of the relay, and the relay is 48 volts DC, 15 amp on the contact. Very simple, a very simple design. So we have the neutral going right up here to the cathode of the SCR, and then we have the live going to the contact and then supplying the whole circuit here. If the contact goes on, it will supply the outlets, the four green outlets on the power strip. As this contact gets closed, there is some voltage running back, and this may actually create some strange feedback, even though the resistor is large, it's 3.3 mega ohms. But I actually did experience some funny stuff going on. Besides all that, I think this circuit is work of a genius. The simpler it is, the better. Just a word about the production cost of this single board, the sensing board. So in a bulk, and by bulk I mean the quantity of 100, you can get these relays for about 60 cents a piece. The same with the current transformer, about 60 cents a piece. And the rest is pennies. So the rest of the thyristor is about 5 cents or less a piece. The resistors are below a penny. Then there's about 1-2 pennies for the capacitor. So it can be can be made very, very cheaply in a mass production. I'm going to use a couple of different items to control this outlet. First of all, I'm going to use the heating mat. This thing is about 25, 30 bucks on Amazon. It says 80 watts. This got a little bit different power consumption than 80 watts. I'll show you in a moment. But it has a little switch mode power supply right here. So you can choose three different options. This is the maximum heat, medium, lowest, and off. And as you look at the watt meter, at the highest setting, it will consume 106.2. When you go to the medium setting, it will go down to 78.8 watts. And then if you go to the lowest, it will go down to 52.8 watts. Now, to see what's happening with the relay, I'm going to plug in this little light. Okay, this is a light that will show us what's going on. So let me unplug it. And now there's no consumption. This is just a little switch mode power supply for the mat. And if I just plug it in, there should be zero. There should be no activity on the relay. But if I do it, I have a few clicks right away. So it is not perfect. It doesn't work perfect with switch mode power supplies. Now let me turn it on to the highest setting. Okay, now it works fine. The light's on the switch outlet. I go to medium. Okay, it's no problem. I go to the lowest setting, and now I have a clicking frenzy. You can hear the relay going berserk, and you can see the light goes on and off, goes crazy. Now, this is a power consumption of 56 watts. Now, what happens if I turn it off? If I turn it off, it quieted down. Okay. Now, so this is the problem with these outlets. They are very simple, as I did show you the schematic. However, there is like a feedback frenzy in some circumstances, especially if you use a switch mode power supply. Now, I'm going to use, instead of that, of the mat, I'm going to use on the control outlet a light incandescent with a simple dimmer. And we'll see what happens now. So there's no, I mean, the only electronics is just a thyristor or one track dimmer. But other than that, the electronics are very simple in this one. So let's just turn it on. And now I'm going to turn on the dimmer and go up with the light. And now we'll see it some moment. Okay. Now we have the light lit. But there's nothing on the output. Let's go a little higher. Now it's on. Okay. And if I look at the power meter, it's 29.3 watts consumed. Now let's go down and see at what point it will turn off the light, and we'll see if there's any flicker. So we go down very gently. And at some point, okay, now it's off. There's no flicker. The light is still on, but it's very low consumption of 11.8 watts. So we can see that with a simple load, with a simple dimmer, works flawlessly. There's no clicking, there's no going berserk. If you go up with the light, with the dimmer, at some point we get on. And again, there's no flicking, there's no problem, and the consumption is 29.1 watts. So what does it mean? It means that this needs to have a very solid on and off power, switch mode power supplies will make it go funny. And this is what the Amazon reviews complained about. People are complaining that when they turn on TV, which always said the new TVs have always switch mode power supplies, the outlets will just click, click. Go berserk and keep clicking. Well, this is the 5 outlet advanced power strip with more sophisticated electronics, and you can see it in my video from 2 months ago. I'm going to link it down in the description. And I'm connecting now to the control outlet. I'm connecting the same pad because giving trouble. to the other strip, and I'm turning it on to the full power, the light went on right away, the control light, okay, and I'm going to the medium setting, there's no problem, 82.7 watts, and I'm going to the lowest setting, it's 56.4 watts on the meter, and I'm going to turn it off. And now we remember that this one does about 8 seconds delay. However, there's no clicking, there's no frenzy, there's no problem whatsoever. It works perfect. In this outlet, it's much more stable. And according to instruction, you need 10 watts to be triggered to turn on. Now we have 8.9 shown on the power meter, and I'm going to turn the dimmer slightly to the right just to exceed the power consumption very slightly. And now at 11, it's actually 13 watts, it went on. And if I turn it down a little bit, just a little bit, to lower the power consumptions, right now 9.7, and this in 8 seconds should probably turn off the light. It did. Okay, well, give a thumbs up if you like this video, find it informative, and thank you for watching.